If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we are going to be continuing on with our Laravel e-commerce series. And what I want to happen is when a user checks out, if they are authenticated, I want this entire form to be filled out and pre-populated with their information. The only thing I don't want on here is a credit card and the name on card. Everything else will be pre-populated. And when they are a guest, they will go to a separate page where they won't have that information filled in and they can go ahead and just fill it out. They can already go ahead and decide if they want to create an account or whatever they want to do. Let's go ahead and start with the authenticated user. Right now we are currently logged in as a user, and what I want to do is I want to open up the inspect tool so we can see what we're getting in from the database. In this index page, if you head down to the user object right down here, you see that we're getting the email, we're getting the name, but we don't actually have our billing details in here, so our address. What we can do is we can head over to the text editor, and something that we can do in here is sort of preload it with our user model. We already have the relationship for billing details, so we can go ahead, paste this in. And so whenever we call that user model, we'll be eager loading the relationship of billing details to that user model. That's the first thing. Let's go ahead and refresh and make sure that we're getting that first. So we should now see some address information here. So now we have billing details, and then we have the address, city, created at, all that good stuff. Let's go ahead and start populating that in the form. Close this. And now we can go to the checkout page. And right down here where we have name, we can do this page, props, user, name, and we can go ahead and do the rest for all of them. Okay, so the first one will be email. Now remember, we just attached that relationship. So we'll say the props, user, this one should also be user. Billing details, address, city, that should be good now. Okay, cool. So now our information has been pre-populated. Fantastic. Now, the other thing I want to do is I want to make this email field right here. Right now, we can click it and we can change it. And I don't want the user to be able to do that. This is just a security measure for our app so that people aren't able to just go and adjust the email in here and end up with a whole mess of problems with the emails. What I want to do is I want to make this disabled so that they can't actually do that. So from here, I want to head up to where we're displaying the email, and I want to put on it disabled. We'll bind a class. Let's go ahead and paste those in. And then we'll say if disabled. Let's give that a try. Okay, well, that looks disabled. Okay, cool. Okay, we can't change it. Fantastic. Okay, so now as usual, we can go ahead and type in a name and add our card. Okay, cool. So we've gotten our confirmation. So once we get to the point where we start removing the quantities from the database, we are going to need a conditional. So basically, if we go ahead and refresh this, in theory, our user should not be able to be on this page. What I mean is this. Let's go to the cart. And I want to remove this item, which means that now we have nothing left in our cart. If we go to the checkout page, we shouldn't be able to access this page. We don't have any items in the cart. There's no reason for us to be on this page at all, and no reason for the user to have access to it. Something that we can do is put in a conditional in the controller. So the first part of how this works is, let's go to the checkout controller and head up to that index function. What we can do is if cart instance default count. And remember, this count is a function from the Laravel shopping cart package that we're using, the bunbunim package. So if that equals zero, then return, redirect, route, shop index. And that's just our main shopping page. Why don't we go ahead and refresh this and see what we get? Remember, we are an authenticated user. We have access to our dashboard, but there's nothing in our cart. Okay, cool. So we're sent back to the dashboard page. And even if we try to type in checkout, it'll redirect us back here. Fantastic. That seems to be working just fine. Now let's go ahead and log out. If we try to head into that checkout page, it's still going to redirect us, which is fine. That is something that we want to do. It's just not quite how we want to get it done. So let's go ahead and add an item into the cart. Now we can go to checkout. And now you see we have an error. And if we take a look at the error, it's because, remember, we are pre-populating the form with the user info. Right now, we have no authenticated user, which means that this page isn't getting any information about a user. So we have to address that. Now, I first want to create a new route. And if we take a look here, our checkout get and our checkout post, they're both available. There's no middleware on any of them. So something we can do too is grab this checkout from here. Bring it down. This is the one for the authenticated user. We can go ahead and create another one. And this I'm going to bring up here. And this one I'm going to call guest checkout. Okay, it's going to be using that same index function. And instead of checkout index, it's going to be guest index, which means that we don't need any middleware around this guest checkout in order to be able to see that page. But we do need to be able to display it here. So back into the controller. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create a conditional, and this conditional is going to say, if auth check, and of course we want to do the negative to the positive. So we're going to say no auth check. Then I'm going to copy this one. And we're going to create another view page and we're going to call it guest. Let me explain this clearly. If someone tries to access these routes, whether it's guest or checkout, if there is no auth user, then that user will be sent straight to the checkout guest page. If they are an authenticated user, then they'll be sent to the checkout index page. We're just redirecting them based on whether or not they are authenticated. This one up top is if there's nothing in the cart, and this one is whether or not they're authenticated. So let's go ahead and create this guest checkout page. What we can do is just really duplicate this one. And we'll just call it guest. And then we'll make our changes accordingly. Everything else is the same except for that email. So let's find that. Email, we don't need this disabled on here. Okay, head down. Okay, that disabled we need for that button. That's fine. We can go down and put these back as quotations. We go down. Everything should be the same because we were able to process the payment previously without it being a guest user or not. Okay, billing details, name, which is fine. Don't forget, we are also going to keep this same route, this checkout route, because we want to make the request to that checkout route. Let's try this and see if it works. What's happening here is that our authentication system is now kicking in. If a user is not registered, they try to hit that checkout page, it's going to redirect them because we have it wrapped around middleware. Okay, right here, that checkout page is now wrapped around middleware, which means our Sanctum, our Jetstream, our Laravel, our authentication, our Fortify is now redirecting it back to the login page, which is exactly what we wanted it to do. So now we can take this guest index route And what we're going to do is now, once we are redirected back into the login page, we'll have the option to either log in, we'll have the option to either get a new account to register our user or to check out as a guest or to continue shopping. So let's go ahead to our login page to add this route. Okay, so check out as a guest, we can add that route finally. And that should be good. So we have a register route and our checkout as a guest route. And let's also go ahead and check the login or the register page and take a look and see, because I think there's one here too. So checkout as a guest, correct. So let's try this and make sure that these links now go to where they're supposed to. Back at the login page, go ahead and click checkout as a guest. Okay, so now we've been brought back to the guest checkout. And if we try to go to checkout manually, again, it's going to send us back to the login page, or let's try it from the register page and make sure that works also. Checkout as a guest. Fantastic. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button, as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to leave links in the description, including the playlist, so that you can catch up on all of the videos in this Laravel e-commerce series. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.